Hello, welcome to Unit 8. This is second revision. We have already seen the first part. This is second part of Unit 8. And we are going to see three topics mainly. They are writing emails, writing summary, and also writing memos. So we will start with writing email. Today, emails have replaced letters. We know that nobody is writing letters nowadays because we have got a better and faster communication, that is email. Most people in companies use emails for a wide range of purposes, not only in the companies, even otherwise, even individuals use emails today. They are mostly to confirm appointments and meetings, request help or action, provide information, etc. So these are some of the purposes for which people send emails. Differences between letters and emails. Emails tend to be less formal. Here, unlike letters, which are more formal, emails are usually less formal. There's no opening and closing. Emails start without name or even salutation, and they are much shorter than letters. And an email will have two usually. It is of course it is the email ID, and of course you have got CC in case you are sending copies to somebody else. Then we have the subject line. If the mail is a reply, there is of course the default subject line, RE, standing for reply. Then the salutation is optional. If you want, you can address people like dear or sir or such kind of salutations. Then we have the reason for writing or the purpose. Then we have the main point. Developing a point is again optional, even additional points only if you think it is needed. Even closing is optional. So you find the emails are much shorter. You don't have all the other extra fittings like letter has. Guidelines for writing emails. It should be brief and clear. Okay, that is the main characteristic of an email. It's very brief and very clear, up to the point. Avoid mistakes and edit carefully before sending. So as far as possible, try to edit the matter you have typed and see there are mistakes, grammatical mistakes or spelling mistakes. Use a plain background to ensure your email is easy to read. Better use always a white background. Then punctuations in emails. Use capital letters where necessary. You should avoid using too many abbreviations. Abbreviations are allowed, but should be limited. Don't use too many of abbreviations. However, there are some standard abbreviations which are generally understood by everybody. Example, like ASAP, standing for as soon as possible, ETC for etc., EG for example, RE for regarding. So these commonly used abbreviations can be allowed. Now we come to writing summaries. What is a summary? A summary is condensed version of a book, article or other piece of writing. It is not a rewritten form of the original. So in CBC syllabus we have got this short notes writing or note making. That is another equivalent to writing summaries. So those who have studied in CBC schools will know what is note making. It is summary. So here what you are trying to do is, after going through that article or a book or any writing, we take the essence of that writing and summarize them in a gist. Give the essence of that writing. That's the meaning of summary. To write a summary, use your own words to express briefly the main idea and relevant details of the piece you have read. The purpose of writing a summary is to give the basic ideas of the original reading. So at the end, what is expected of you is to give a summary as far as possible in your own words. Try not to use or even copy the essence or copy the ideas of the original. We can use words definitely, but it's not a kind of cut and paste process. You have to use only the essential points. All the irrelevant points or sentences can be avoided. Now let's see the procedure to make a summary. The first thing is that we understand the material that you are handling. What is it actually? Whether it's an article, whether it's a book, or it's a story. Try to identify the purpose of the reading. Why the author has written that? What is the purpose or intention of the writer? Then identify what type of text you are dealing. Whether it is an article, a story, or a research paper, or whatever. Then skim the text and identify the main idea of the text, noting in your mind the titles and subtitles and highlight the important points. So it's a kind of filtering. You just go through the whole passage once or twice. You are skimming here. That means you are looking for important points. That is kind of filtering. You throw out all the unwanted materials or unwanted points. You pick and choose only the most important points from a particular paragraph. Read with who, what, when, where, why, and how questions in mind and take notes. So as you read through the passage, maybe a second time or third time, you underline the important points. That is kind of filtering. And as you are going through, you should be having these WH questions in your mind, like who, what, when, where, why, and how. Because these questions should be answered in your summary. Those are the important points. Write down main points in your own words. So when you are summarizing, maybe three or four sentences will become one. So you will have to remodel the whole sentence. Maybe one paragraph you can summarize into one or two sentences. Go through the process again, making changes as appropriate. So you'll have to go through the whole process once again to see whether any modification is necessary. The summary should cover the original as a whole. That means you cannot leave out any important point. All the essential points should be there. Otherwise, it will be incomplete. The material should be presented in a neutral fashion, the author's view. That means when you are writing in your own words, you be very careful that you don't add your own ideas. You should still stick to the ideas given by the author. It should not be subjective. As far as possible, try to be objective. That's the meaning of being neutral. Your own idea should not be inserted in that. The summary should be the condensed version of the material presented in your own words. So that's the idea. It has to be condensed. It has to be very, very short without losing the essence of that material. But in your own words. Now we come to writing memos. What is a memo? A memo is a short for memorandum and is usually normally used for communicating policies, procedures, or related official business within an organization. So usually memos are usually used in a institution or company to communicate within that group. That means from the higher ups, those who are below, they get memos. It may be to communicate certain policies of the company or certain procedures or things related to business. A memo's purpose is to inform others about new or changed policy, procedures, organizational details, but it occasionally includes an element of persuasion. So usually the company wants to inform certain policy changes, certain procedures or organizational details. Besides that, there will be also some kind of even instructions or orders given to the employees. Here are some uses of memos. First of all, it is to announce meetings, events, changes. Then to present decisions, directives, proposals and briefings. Directive means giving direction, maybe future, what you are supposed to do and all that, maybe kind of certain targets. Then also to transmit documents, internal documents. You can transfer to the people in that particular group. Three steps in writing memos. They are preparation, writing and review. In preparation, we have determining the purpose, topic and reader's needs. So here you are deciding why you are writing this memo, what is the purpose, and the topic and also the reader's needs. Those who are reading it, what are their needs? Then writing and organizing. That means after writing, you organize it in order. Then the last one is review. That is revising and editing. Just like in other writing, you have revising and editing. Just like in academic writing. And then the memo format. First we have the company name or the department name on top. If it is a letterhead, we don't need that, it's already there. Then the heading, then to, who gets it, and from, and then the date. Then you have the subject, what is it about, and then the body. It conveys the message, the most important part. And then you have the introduction, main points and closing the memo. Memo style. Concise. That means make your sentences, paragraph and overall memo as brief and as focused as possible. So here memos are purely business purpose. So it has to be condensed, it has to be very precise and brief. No extra words, no extra explanations and all that. Then clear. Get your purpose straight before you start. Then plan what you want to say and in what order. So some planning has to be done before you write the memo. Use your memo layout to help your reader. That is like heading, then bulleted list, white space as appropriate. So if you have a clear layout, it will easily convey the message to the reader. Then direct. Speak directly to your reader as you would in person or on the phone. So it's a kind of direct communication. So it should be like a kind of interaction, as if you are talking to that person direct. Do not pad your ideas with unnecessary details. Again, no extra or unnecessary details. Think of what questions your reader wants to be answered and then answer them. So you can also think of certain clarifications, what the reader may arise. Then you try to answer those questions also in your memo. Then clean. That is reread, revise, copy edit and proofread. These are the things you should read before finalizing it. Going through that drafting, revising, copy editing and also proofreading. Then only you go to the final draft. Subject line. It summarizes the main ideas. Think of it as being preceded by the words, "This memo is about." Then comes the subject matter of your memo. Then we have introductory paragraph. It quickly informs the reader about what the memo is. Then we have the purpose of your writing, why you are writing. That is the introductory paragraph. Then supply any relevant background information or identify any task the memo is related. So these are some of the things you should keep in mind while writing the memo. Then you have the body paragraph, which conveys information and supporting details relevant to the memo's purpose. So what are the information you are trying to give? The body. Keep paragraph short and focused. One main idea per paragraph. So if you have got too many points, then try to stick to one point, one idea in a particular paragraph. Not too many ideas. Keep sentences tight and informative. You should not have any loose end. Try to give only what is essential or necessary. Use bullets to list information. If you have a list, try to put bullets before that. That means point by point. It will be easy for the reader to understand. Then the close, ending. End courteously, means with respect. Maybe you can think of a phone call or face-to-face meeting. In case it is necessary, means you can think about that. Stating any expected outcome, action or other information appropriate to your purpose. In case you expect people to contact you or maybe what is that result you are expecting, that also you can state. For example, please send me your comments and suggestions by January 16th. So that is one way of closing your memo. Or let us meet next week to go over the next stage in the plan. So you are looking ahead to the future plan, and that also could be one way of ending your memo. So with that, we have come to the end of memo writing. So we'll have one more class of unit 8, the third part, by which we'll end unit 8. Till then, it is goodbye. Thank you.